Residents in Sydney's north got a reminder this morning of the shoddy state of the city's electricity network, which even power bosses now admit can be dangerous. Thousands of homes and businesses were blacked out at a time when we're all being forced to pay more for power.
Police on point duty and chaos on the roads after a power failure stretching from Belrose to Killarney Heights that struck before dawn. 40,000 people had a workday morning without electricity.
When we got here at 6 o'clock, everything was still blacked out. So it sort of put us behind about a couple of hours.
I was feeding him down the end room and all the power went out. And I didn't know whether to yell out and get someone to come and help me.
I couldn't blow dry my hair, couldn't straighten my hair, couldn't have toast.
The culprit was a possum that strayed into a substation, but Ausgrid is facing another, more serious issue. Ageing equipment causes more blackouts. Parts of this substation at Cramer blew up in 2010, sparking a costly replacement program and safety warnings for staff. 36 substations from Sydney South all the way to Newcastle have been found to have faulty and potentially explosive fuses, and Ausgrid is being forced to upgrade them.
The service is terrible that we get from the electricity company. We should get a lot better service. We pay heaps of money.
Ausgrid says its blackout record is on par with its competitors.
Well, on average, there's around about one blackout a year for every customer across our network, and they generally last around about 100 minutes.
Electricity prices have already risen 18% under Mr. O'Farrell, yet we're seeing increased problems to reliability, and I fear with hundreds of job losses to come, these problems will become greater.
John Hill, 10 News.